people in the athletic department. One, I think you're right. I am a guy that's, I gather information, and I want to really understand the decision to get ready to make about, you know, where you're headed. And I bought my grinder, and maybe to a fault sometime, but most of the time, I don't think so. What I have found out about the athletic department is some incredibly talented people there and within the athletic department. You know, the whole, we've discussed this on air before, so I don't know, the whole issue of leadership is such an important thing. And you know, we struggle, but we have stability now. It really is at the president's level and board level. I think athletic director, chancellor level, you know, and so things are different. It's we're getting to know each other this past year. A lot of good things have happened, but there's been a real struggle from a leadership standpoint with the team. But in the athletic department, there's some people that I'm working with that have been under four athletic directors, and that's difficult, you know. But they are talented. And, I wasn't sure when I went in if there was going to be, you know, whoever hired them, are they going to be loyal to me in Tennessee, or are they, you know, what are they about? I have found that they're very loyal to Tennessee, and they really want us to get back to where we were, and it doesn't matter who's sitting in that chair. So I've been impressed. That would be my answer to the team that we have now. We've adjusted some assignments and responsibilities, and had some serious talks about, you know, our goals and our tools, and, you know, how we're going to get to where we want to go.
We're going to talk about that in today's show. I want to start with basketball, big win yesterday. What an excellent season going on right now. But I want to talk to you, when you were my turn here in purgatory for a while, up in the Nashville, you got to know Rick Barnes, not as a coach, but personally because of some interaction with him. Give the folks a thought about him as a person, because you knew him well before that, before you knew anything about him as a coach.
I did. And one of them in my background at Texas, in 99 with friends, and you know, we talked about all kinds of things outside of football, and so I knew of him. And then while I was in purgatory, I was in a Bible study class with him, and it was great getting to know him and hearing his story and, you know, how he, you know, came to Tennessee, but more importantly, his philosophy and how the life and everything, you know, his changes over the years. He was a running gun, you know, kind of guy early in his career, you know, like a lot of us were. He's got great faith, you know, loves his family, loves his players. Was obvious in that moment, so I took time to go see him play. It couldn't be one because of Tennessee, but two because I wanted to see Rick's teams play. And he came off of a mess too, you know, or inherited a mess, to be honest. And watching his team play and fight for balls, always back on defense, you know, scrambling for everything, and you know, but they were 500, I think, about the first year, something like that. But they were losing to Kentucky by 6 or 10, you know, not getting blown out. Those kinds of things are fighting. It reflects a bit of personality. And next year they're a little bit better, and now we're where we are, competing for, you know, for the championship. And it's just great to see. And it's great to see a guy that doesn't cheat, you know, does it fair, you know, gets after the kids, but loves them. And even one time he told me, he says, I don't ever raise my voice to the players. I said, Rick, I've been here practicing. You're the only skeleton of the 10, you're a 9 all the time. So technically, you might not measure voice, but you're getting after pretty good. But they respect him. And the results said, you know, on the court. I mean, he's matured those guys into a really, really fine basketball team.
I guess if your voice is at high level anyway, you don't raise it. It's just always. Well, let's get in some more important. No, well, not really more important things. But National Signing Day, early period. Tennessee, I think, what, 17, 18, somewhere right in there.
I think 18 now, 19, something like that. that, you know, was expected in Tennessee, and we had been part of those teams. We had a lot of good teams, but it was kind of up and down, you know. And if you're going to compete for a championship, you've got to have those players. I mean, you can have, you know, the best coaches in the world, but they don't have the players, you're not going to win. And you also, in this conference, it's depth, so it's not just the 11 best. You better be, you know, too deep everywhere that you possibly can, and able to overcome injuries and those kind of things late in the year. So I spent a lot of time and trust in my system, you know, as a head coach, and stay involved with both offense, defensively, and the kicking game. But it's my day to mind the offense. I stay on top of that. The offense ran the defense for the most of the time that I was there. And I stayed on top of that, was involved in the kicking game. At about 8 o'clock at night, I got to my office and started recruiting Eastern time. And then when it got to be 10 o'clock or 11 o'clock, I started Central time. And then when it got later, I started on the other coach, Mr. Tuckshin. I said, Jeremy is the same kind of recruiter. He's very intense about being involved and understanding, you know, what's the winning edge on each play. And gets to know